called Four Royal Dances. The composer is Eric Raisin. And these are four dances to depict four people in a castle. So there's the lord, the lady, the jester, and the knight. So there are four short movements. Raisin is an American composer born in the early 1950s. Written a lot of commissions for orchestras, bands, all kinds of ensembles and things like that. So again, there's four short movements, and you can think about if it sounds like the lord or the lady of the castle, hopefully the jester, and then the knight.
Thank you.
Procession for you does not need any introduction. You will know this music. Feel free to enjoy. I want to thank Yuba Sutter Oratorio Society for inviting us to play, and Corey Kersting for working with our students, and all of you for being here. It's nice for us to play for a nice audience, and it's been a lot of fun, I know, for this group to play with the Yuba Sutter Symphony. So we thank you for that opportunity, and this is some Phantom of the Opera.
Thank you. great videos of string players breaking a string during a solo with an orchestra. And I've seen, thankfully, that wasn't a broken string, just it came off the peg, and so he fixed it real good. But where there's a violinist, and they break a string, and they pass their violin just to someone else in the orchestra, and they take their violin, and I've seen one video where a soloist throws a string in the violin section, and it gets passed all the way back to the back, and someone fixes the string, and passes it back up to the front, and a couple minutes later, they're back on their regular violin again. So, the joys of live performance. So, this piece we're going to play is the Rite of the Valkyries. If you're saying, what is that piece, you will recognize it when we play it. And the composer is not Wagner, it's Wagner. Everyone say Wagner. While we're talking about pronunciation, let's not say Mozart, let's say Mozart. And Wagner. They did not live at the same time, but those are names that I have some little pet peeves when I hear them said spoken incorrectly. The Rite of the Valkyries comes from the opera, The Valkyrie, and it's about 5 minutes long. And it's been used many, many places, many times. Actually, one of my kids was watching this little cartoon the other day, and in the cartoon, one of the characters has a cell phone, and the cell phone starts ringing, and it's playing the Rite of the Valkyries. So, anyway, you will definitely recognize it, and we hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. for our final two pieces. And the donations get shared between both Yuba Sutter Symphony and the Yuba Sutter Youth Symphony for this performance, so just so you know that. But if you happen to be writing a check, if you want to write a check during intermission, you can write out to YSOS, Yuba Sutter Oratory Society. And like I said, you'll have an opportunity to do that later. But right now, let's take about a 10-minute intermission. Thank you. I normally don't have to play MC at this concert, so I messed up our sponsor of Union Bank. I said US Bank, so Union Bank, so thank you to Union Bank. If you look in your program like I should have, you'll see our full list of sponsors. And it is a growing list. We're really excited about the support that we've been getting from our community to help cover some of our costs. If you or your business or you as an individual might be interested in sponsoring our full season or one of our concerts, there's a phone number on the back of the program that you can call to talk about being a future sponsor. We are going to play a piece of music called the Polovetsian Dances, and this is by the Russian composer Borodin. It's about 10, 12 minutes long, and it's from an opera called Prince Igor. And this piece in the opera, it actually has a chorus that goes along with many of the dances, but we don't have a chorus, and it's often played just as an orchestral work. So you'll hear several different styles of dances throughout the piece with a lot of energy. And the beginning is very lyrical and really beautiful, so we hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. being in a service where you might hear hymns played and songs of memory. But even then, there's a positive theme to it, because there's a recognition that in loss, there is still tremendous opportunity to experience life. And what I mean by that is leading into the third section, which is called Heroes. And the stories started to come out from the campfire of amazing people. I mean, you don't know that the person next door to you is amazing until your houses are on fire and he saves your life, you know? And so as a result of hearing the stories and then seeing the immense sacrifices that people have made in coming to the aid of those who needed it, it's inspiring. And tragedy has led to inspiration. And that's really what the piece is all about, is recognition of the tragedy and the weight of the loss, but as well, the last section, Heroes, a triumphant reminder that because of what we've experienced among the people we've been with, we're better for it, and we're among better people. And we live in a day and age where our differences constantly divide us, and it is situations like the campfire that kind of purify some of that and bring us back together and remind us that we're human together, and these greater needs of caring for each other outweigh the differences that are there, and that's why it ends on a note of triumph. So I hope you enjoy tonight. Thanks.
Thank you. Thank you so much for coming. Take your programs with you on the back corner for upcoming dates for both the Yuba Sutter Symphony and the Youth Symphony. And drive home safely. Have a great night. Thank you.